Hi you guys, Radiation here. I just started a new Fallout 4, just got the game back, figured why not, I'll make a short video on it, and I made a new person, new character. I'm just now leaving Vault 111. I tried my hardest to make him look like me, didn't really like it, so I put a beard on him. Everything else is about the same. Alright, let's get started on this video because I'm kind of getting bored sitting here. And you guys are probably getting bored watching it. There's one thing that I hate. It's when people make a video and sit there talking about themselves for like 20 minutes. So they have a longer video. That annoys the crap out of me. I'm going to try to move as fast as I can and explain some stuff that you guys will not have on your Fallout, probably if you guys have internet. See, the reason that I like to not have internet is because with me not having internet, none of the glitches get blocked or the ways to buy free stuff, none of that gets blocked. I can do all of it. And I think that's pretty cool. So I kind of keep my PS4 off the internet so I cannot get those updates, because I don't want those updates. I want to be able to do what I want to do, really. Oh, God. All right, let's get started on this video. I'll show you some of the things that you can still do. Some places to get some good stuff, some starter stuff. Everyone knows the Sanctuary Hills. Basically, the first mission's right there. You basically go and search around with Codsworth. Before you leave the vault, you can actually get almost 100 bullets for your 10 millimeters, so that'll hold you over for a while, but I'm gonna go ahead and skip that first mission just to get started with this video and show you guys why you should not get internet on your PS4. So a lot of people know about this guy right here. He's got the pipe pistol and the drifter outfit, but not a lot of people know about this. So, just, you know, whenever you pass that guy on the road, just jump up here next to the statue, and there's a little bag there that's got a pipe rifle, and usually it has some kind of grenade in it, and then it has ammo. Now, everyone knows the Red Rockets, where you get your first companion.
Hey, boy, what are you doing out here all by yourself?
You want to come with me, pal?
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
So, basically, a lot of people make videos on, like, the best setups to do for your perks. It's not really a good setup. It's what you want to do. Basically, since I chose I want to basically be invincible by the time I beat the game, I'm going to do a lot of endurance. So I have damage resist, I can drink water, I can gain more health, I can fucking, you know, I can just be basically invincible. And then I basically went through and I got Gun Nut, I got these two, Blacksmith and Forger. I did not get Science. Wait, that's not the right one. Where'd it go? This, no. I don't know where the hell it's at. I didn't get it, though. I know that for a fact. I thought it was this one. It's in Intelligence. Anyway, science is just pointless to me. I don't ever use laser guns. I don't want to bore you guys to death. I don't know if you guys use VATS, however you want to say it. I can't use it right now. Basically, I'm gonna go through this town just to get some of these guys killed. Take care of some of them. I'll make another video on how to get Dog Meat's complete armor set. I actually just found it the other day. So, I'm gonna go ahead and I'll show you guys that video. I'll make a video on that. It's actually really, it's really cool because you don't really have to do much. Let me get some. They got crappy armor. Whoa, leveled up. That's why that happened. I just seen my health go from down and it shot up real fast. So I was like, oh, hello. Basically, I'm gonna get started early with the invincible thing. Make it hell of a lot harder to kill me. I'm gonna go ahead and skip their mission for a while. I'll come back to it. There's a power suit I want on the roof, everything like that. Basically, I'm gonna... I think that's her diner. Yeah. I'm gonna run up here to this diner, and I'm gonna show you guys a cool glitch that you can do, but... Oh, hell. There's Trash Can Carl. I'll just do it here. Excuse basically,
so
as long...
What's your story? Looking to trade? Rob me? Or just ask directions?
Mm-hmm. Let's see what you've got.
Oh, I have a little bit of everything.
Alright, so basically, as long as you have one bullet, or, you know, as many bullets as you want, I'll do it with the 8 bullets, or one bobby pin, or a Molotov cocktail, really anything in your inventory, I'll do it with the bullet just because it's easy. You go here, and you'll give her one bullet. Let's say I want more 308 rounds. I click X, because I'm on PS4. And then you're going to click square and X together. And if that doesn't work, you're going to have to click square like a millisecond before you click X. It's kind of confusing, but if it says confirm trade... You know you did it right, because now I have 13 308 rounds. Let's see here. What do I want now? I'm going to go ahead and... I'm going to take the 10mm rounds, because that's what I'm using right now. And just because I know it's not going to be that much hassle, I'm going to take one 10mm round away from me. Go down here. You click X on it. You click square and X together. Clicks confirm trade. Now I have 148. And it's taking no caps from me. Now, if you go and you sell stuff, all right, I confirm trade. I got 29 caps. Watch my caps. You're not going to like this if you're trying to save up caps. Do not do this. I mean it. If you're trying to save up caps, do not do this. Because still takes away your money. Which kind of sucks, but it does. Now, I'm going here to the 308. Took away $434 from me. Took away all my money. Basically, it's going to keep you at $0 your entire game. Which will suck if you're trying to save up money. So like I said, don't do it if you're trying to save up money. It's that simple. Actually, if you're trying to get a new gun that's better than the one you're currently using,
Do that. Trade the gun out for the other gun. It's basically a trade. I always do this. I always set my gun as that. So basically you don't equip it. You just go like that. Boom.
We had a deal, Trudy. Hand over the goods.
These people are usually too high level to fight on low level, but you know what? I'm level 2, and I'm gonna kill them. Oh, dang. Got him right in the freaking ear. I actually like that set of armor. I've always taken it. I'm gonna go ahead and take it and equip it. I normally keep my vault gear because, well, you can customize it in the armor stations. I just like this armor set because it looks cool. Basically, that is my everyday attire. Right there. I'm always wearing a leather jacket. I don't wear leather pants. Fuck that. Screw that. That's gross. That's almost exactly what my leather jacket looks like, except for, you know, mine's more new than that. It doesn't have cuts in the back, blah, blah, blah. That's kind of obvious. Basically,
hey,
what I'm going to do is I'm about to show you that you could do it with... You could do that...
Here, this is for you. Now... If you ever need to...
You can do that trade with any person, anywhere, anytime, anything, really. You trade anything and you can buy anything. Just to show you, you can get legendaries. Easiest way to get legendaries. Confirm trade. Show you that I got it. Do dog meat move. Go into your weapons. Look at that. Got it perfectly. Now, of course, there are disadvantages to having no internet on your PS4. Like, other games suck because there's no internet for them. That's why I have an Xbox One, a PS4. Xbox One's connected to the internet, PS4's not. PS4 is just for me to fuck around on Fallout, basically. Of course, another disadvantage is you can't have mods. You know, you can't make people look like big penises or whatever the fuck you want to do. I don't know. Whatever you want to do. Basically, that's the gist of this video. You know, I know in my last videos I'd say, you know, smash that like button, hit the subscribe button. I don't really mind in this video. Basically, I'm just trying to get this through as fast as possible. And, I don't really think I'm going to have much time to do that. I don't remember what I have my time set for. So basically, the video will shut off whenever it shuts off. At the Starlight Drive-In, a lot of people just go pick that door. It's a lot easier to run up here, grab the back storage key. Plus, you get a melon, shit like that. I don't usually use this as my base. I'm gonna go ahead and do it for this series of videos, though. So, it's just gonna make it a lot easier since I'm already here. The reason I don't use it as a base is because it does not have very many strategic advantages. Well, can't talk today. Happens to be the worst day not to be able to talk because I'm making a YouTube video today. This sword actually is a very good sword. It does 50% more damage against robots, but still does pretty good damage against any other enemy, too. Also considering the fact that the serrated blade allows you to cut off their limbs easier. Alright, come here, fucker.
He's coming. There's no fucking enemy. I don't know what the fuck. Always, before you go in this room, you might want to disarm that, take that. And then go in. Of course, there's that trap there that I always forget about. Gets you a Nuka Cherry, which is actually, I guess, pretty rare, because I find Nuka Cola Quantums more than I find these. Let's see here.
I'm basically going to do videos on how to get good guns, how to get good armor, how to max out your person, your character, the fastest. What the hell's up with my aim? There you go. Along the railroads, actually a pretty good place to start. I figured that out. It's a good place to start simply because railway guns. No joke, that's where you get most of your railway guns. If I'm right, I might actually be pretty close to the set of dog armor. Then again, I probably don't know what I'm talking about because I'm fucking psycho all the time. If you like my videos, please subscribe to DePlasma. Look him up. He's kind of got a weird little picture, but look him up. He's hilarious, makes some pretty funny Gmods videos. He plays with another one of my best buds. So hit him up, watch his videos. I think you're gonna laugh. He's really funny. If I'm right, this is actually the place where you get a railway gun. We're at here? I don't really remember, but you get it here, I think. Gonna go ahead and just kind of cheat these guys out of their cat. It's not actually smart to use stim packs the way that I use them, but I do, so what the hell. Oh, let's keep breaking up. Basically, when you come to a place that has a lot of railway spikes, or it's got that means that this is a dead drop. Basically, it's just gonna have shit ton of shit in it that the railroad drops there. And if you, you know, wait a certain amount of time, sometimes they'll fill it back up. So, just, if you ever see a little symbol like that, a little square with little lights around it, always check it. I'm dead serious. Sometimes there's, like, legendaries and shit in it. Of course, not like name legendaries, but legendaries. Good ass guns. Just to be short. I'm thinking that this is the place where you get that railway gun. Now those little shits do give you a lot of radiation, because they're little shits, and why the hell would they not? Oh yeah, I've learned this one, this from playing this game. It's best to just go through, and every time you see duct tape, take the son of a bitch, because every time you're trying to modify your gun, you need adhesive. I've gotten sick and tired of running out of adhesives, so I just go around and fucking collect as much fucking duct tape as possible. Fucking, oh yeah, desk fans too. Collect those. This is a safe house for the railroad, which is why there's a railway gun here. You just basically gotta fucking find it. Which is the hard part. I don't know. This place, it's got a railway gun at it. Look around, I bet you find it. Can I close this one? No, because it's on the ground. I don't know. Let's get back to the video. This is probably going to be a pretty boring video. Just going to have to listen to me talk. I know my mic's really shitty, but that was a weird hiccup. So if you don't want to, you know, if you want to find it on your own after watching this video, the dog armor for dog meat, if you use dog meat still, a lot of people I know, they don't use him, which is kind of crazy because he's awesome. He's a cute little puppy and he follows you around. The dog armor is along the highway, so you just got to keep following the highway and you'll find it. There is a enemy base near it. Just warning you. Look at that, Nuka Cherry. Man, I spoke too soon. Now I'm finding them everywhere. Doggy, stop whining like a little baby. Who? Now, I know for a... Oh, never mind. Okay, alright, okay. Never had one of them motherfuckers shoot that fast before. Never, ever, ever motherfucking got shot by one of those motherfuckers shoot that fast. Basically, the plane kinda rotates between enemies. First, usually I've always had super mutants first, but this time I had Mr. Gusties. So, it goes like super mutant, I guess Mr. Gusties. Raiders and ghouls. That's about it. Sometimes gunners. Never really had gunners, though. Oh, by the way, everyone, I just got a new pair of beats that are pretty fucking awesome. If I can figure out how to... Are you fucking kidding me? All the way back here. All the fucking way back... Ooh. I'm pissed. My dog will take care of that dog. That's a weird bus. Where the hell's the back? Never been in this way for the thicket. This guy gives you a good reward if you go and do his stupid little task. Also, make sure I have some like Radex or something.
I'm gonna go ahead and show you this. I don't. But I can get some later. I'm gonna go ahead and show you this. Be fearless, guys. Go for a swim. If you go to the thicket, go for a swim. I'm in the water, yeah. I'm not taking radiation damage, meaning I'm not in the water anymore. There's a chest down here somewhere.
There's another way to tell you that I'm not in the fucking water. There's dog meat. If you walk too far out, you go back in the water. That's how you know when you've walked too far out. Also because I can drink it like a waterfall. But it's a water wall, really. I guess there's not a box back here yet, but one does come back here. I feel... it's doing that glitch again. My PS4 is a little glitchy sometimes. To warn the people watching my videos, and then, you know... Anyways, to get back out of this secret little spot down there, you'd simply just find stairs, which these happen to be a little close. If I can get on there. There we go. I've learned from my mistake there. Ba-bam. You're out. Nah, I don't really like doing the guy's mission, though. It's kind of annoying. It annoys me. It'd be cool if, like, he'd drain it and it just, like, right before your eyes, be drained. But it's not! Yay. I talk too much. These aren't stairs. Well, it got me surprised. I don't know. This is just the beginning of my new character. I'll post a lot. I'll post a couple videos up at one time when I post this up. Lost all my armor. That's fucking amazing. All right. So, as of now, because I've never actually said this before, I'm gonna go ahead and kind of steal this from Markiplier. I will see you in my next video. See you later.